We all know that the climatic variability is happening quite rapidly. And when this climate is changing, temperature is one of the key factors which is driving most of these changes. But some of the recent analysis have shown that it is the high nighttime temperature, that is the warming night temperature, which is more so important and is significantly predicted to induce negative impacts on crops, leading to yield and quality. As of now, we really don't have a system that can actually capture these responses under the field conditions. So what you see behind me here is a prototype of something that we have developed where we can actually introduce warmer nighttime temperatures and see how the wheat actually responds and if there is a reduction in an yield or quality losses.
So I think if you look at this, Raju, at the top part of that, that's completely dry. Yeah, yeah. At the lower part, it's still a little bit green, right?
Yeah.
So if you are going to take some measurements, you might still get something at the bottom.
The overall bigger aim of this project is to build much bigger tents of this kind to actually introduce much greater genetic diversity and also bring in the genetic components for the breeders to be able to have markers to develop our wheat, which is more resilient to high night temperatures into the future.
Yeah, I think this is a really important project because as we look forward in breeding, it's 10 to 12 years from the time we make a cross till we release something. And as we start to deal with these additional stresses, it's really important to have the tools to do that. So this project really sets the stage for us to evaluate materials, understand the genetics behind heat tolerance, and then look at new genetics as it comes along for its ability to handle these higher temperatures. And so I see this as critical information that feeds into breeding as it helps all the breeders, whether it's the K-State program or private programs or programs around the world, really understand heat tolerance and how to deploy it.
The whole idea is to introduce warmer nighttime temperatures after flowering, which is basically what happens in Kansas, where there is more warming happening during the grain filling phases. This has been going on for about 3 weeks now. So we intend to have this sort of a stress introduced onto the crop for about 4 weeks, and after that the stress will be taken off and then you actually start to see the impact. In the process of doing all this, we have taken a lot of physiological measurements and a lot of spikes on the leaf samples have been taken. All these samples were taken at 4 o'clock in the morning when it was pitch dark. So all this will undergo molecular analysis to be able to come out with some markers that can be utilized for improving our wheat.